How did the logjam break up?
Well, we had been talking about this agreement before we indicted the case. So this is pretty much what we expected, the way the case would go.
10 years for someone who caused that much damage, that will come as a surprise to some people.
Well, and the sentencing guidelines call for a more severe sentence. But we took a look at this case, and we felt that because of his youth and because of other factors, that a little leniency was in order here.
What sort of factors? You have a mental health evaluation. He was found competent to stand trial, but he does have a troubled past. Is that what you're saying?
Well, typically in arson cases, we have a profit motive. If you remember Papadopoulos fire, some of the other prominent arsons we had in the city over the years, there's been fraud associated with it or some other malevolent motive to committing the crime. This is a kid, 23 years old at the time he committed the arson, with no apparent profit motive or other evil intent in mind, kind of just a stupid act.
Remarkably lucid in court today.
We have no concerns about his competency. In fact, as Mr. Griffin indicated, he's off any kind of medication. It wasn't apparently believed that he needed medication anymore. So I have no concerns about his competency.
There are other, I guess, was it 3553 factors? Tell us about those.
3553 factors are a way for the court to individualize sentencing, to look at specific factors characteristic of the defendant and work that into the advisory sentencing guidelines so as to tailor a sentence specific to the individual.
If not for this plea deal, he could have gotten, what was the maximum sentence he was facing?
The maximum statutory sentence would be 40 years.
For each count, or?
No, 20 years for each count. The maximum he would be looking under the advisory sentencing guidelines is about 181 months.
He also pled guilty to a Sacramento County case. Can you tell us anything about that?
He's agreed to plead guilty in Sacramento County Superior Court to a separate arson charge. That involved his grandmother's house on Cheviot Hills. He will do that sometime between today and sentencing in this case.
He could be in court this afternoon in Sacramento County?
I wouldn't expect it to be that soon, but within the next couple of weeks.
When did that happen?
That fire occurred about 3 weeks before the arsons in the federal case.
A lot of damage? We hadn't heard about that before.
Not extensive damage.
Regarding this agreement, did it speak to the difficulty of getting a conviction at all, or was it just a...
Not at all. If you look at our factual basis to the plea agreement, you can see that it was a strong case. This speaks more to giving a break to a kid who did a stupid act.
Did Roseville or Westfield people have any input on the plea?
No. Well, that was certainly a factor. It was certainly a free and easy interview. I think it was about a 20-minute conversation, and he just came right out with it. So it was a free and voluntary confession.